Hi guys, it's Heather here at the Kraaft Shaak, and I am trying to get so much stuff done before the surgery. So, I thought that I would do something really quick. It was something that I was working on earlier, and I thought, you know what? I didn't record that. I'm going to record it and make a quick video for you guys. So, what you're staring at here are a small palette of some cool colors that I put together of PanPastels, and I'm not going to worry about the coloring so much, but I wanted you to see that that's the colors that I'm using, a pan pastels. I'm going to also be using Versamark watermark stamp pad, some stamps, and what else? Oh, and some magicals. And I've got these really awesome colors that I pulled out. So we're going to play with these, and I'm going to show you something really fun. I'm also going to try and do Finnabair's mica powders as well, and see if we can do something fun with those. So let's just play and see what we can do. Yeah, I think that'll work. Okay, we'll just go with that. Okay, so this is just so off the cuff here. I'm going to do this in real time. I'm not going to edit this video. I'm just going to put it out there, and hopefully you'll enjoy it. That's what this and that Thursday is all about, right? And while I'm getting my surgery done, you guys can be enjoying this. I hope that will be positive for everybody. So I've got this big rose stamp, and it's actually a two, you know, like a two-stage stamp. Probably familiar with those where you stamp like the bottom shadow part, and then you stamp this over the top of that in a darker color, and then it has like these great whatever you call that gradient shaded look to it. That's always wonderful, but not for this particular technique. We're just going to use it, just this portion of it, to create a gorgeous background. And a super easy background. Now, if you don't have pan pastels, you could still do this with any kind of chalking medium. If you're not familiar with chalking mediums, they come in different ways. Different companies have called them different things over the years. That's way easier, but it hurts my hands. So, and actually, I can just double stamp this one over here. It doesn't have to be perfect because the perfection comes out in the fun of the chalk here, the pastel. Okay, so I didn't realize I had multiple sheets there. Okay, so here we go. So I'm just going to take this bright magenta color, whatever the heck the colors are. I hope you don't care. We're not worried about that. We're just worried about the technique. And this is just a big soft sponge, one of the wedge sponges, and I'm just going to rub the color over the top of it here and there. And I'm being really messy with it. I want you to see that. It doesn't have to be perfect. And I'm rubbing it into some areas and I'm just whooshing over the top of others, okay? I should put the lid on my Versamark pad. There we go. Now, same sponge going into the darker, whatever purplish color that is. And we're going to kind of go over these and just blend it together. And look at how those pan pastels blend together. This is why they're totally worth themselves. I know they're a little bit pricey, but when you buy a kit that has multiple colors in it, you're actually getting a tremendous deal. You always get tools with your sets when you buy even just a set of five colors. You still get tools with that. So, you know, it's worth every penny, I really do think. And they last forever. I mean, as you see here, what I'm using just to do this particular project, even with what little bit is getting wasted on the sides over here, not much is coming off of that pan. They're going to last a long, long time. This is a medium. When you invest in this medium, you're going to love it. And I'm just going back and forth in the two colors, and it doesn't even matter. I haven't even cleared off the sponge or anything. All right, there's our background. Ta-da. And isn't that amazing? I love that. Okay, so that's a technique you've seen before. It's probably not new to you. If it is new to you, then voila. Then I take the smaller rose, and we're going to do the same thing on top of this color. So I'm going to go randomly. Notice that you can't see it or anything. It didn't remove the pastel. That's because the pastel doesn't really come off. Even on this is just regular cardstock. It's no big deal. This stamp pad is driving me crazy. Good enough. Okay. Now, I don't know if you'll be able to see this on the light where some of those roses are. Not really. Okay. Now I'm going to take one of these Lindy Stamp Gang Magicals. This is one of my favorite products that I carry in the store and that I've ever used in my whole life, to be honest with you, just because of how magical it is. And I'm not trying to be funny. It's appropriately named magicals. So this one is called Sweet Violet Purple Teal, and I think the fact that it's named that is why I love it the most. But anyway, I've got a dry filbert brush. Doesn't really matter what shape it is, but a rounded edge is nice. And then I'm just going to go over any place that I know I stamped. And I'm just going to spread this out all over where I stamped those images. And I don't really care about getting it all over the whole thing. I don't have to avoid those larger roses. They've been covered with pan pastel, so they don't really have anything on them. They're not sticky anymore. And there. Make sure we get all of these things covered. Here's a couple more over here. Yeah, that's nice. Now, you may notice my background, my craft sheet has a bunch of stuff on it. Leave that. You can spritz it with water and put some card in. We might even do that before we say goodbye, but just want to show you what takes place when you do this. You might have gotten a hint of it there. I'm just going to take a dry paper towel and gently go across the top of the whole thing. That'll get rid of any excess powder, dust, pastel, whatever, like I said. And now the magic. So when you look at it straight on, it looks like that. And then the camera will hopefully pick up that blue teal shimmer that comes from that magical. And as I rub over the top of it, I get some extras off, but after a while, it won't be any extra on there if you just rub it with that paper towel. You're basically pushing it into the cardstock. So that's just regular cardstock like you would use in your scrapbooking endeavors, and pretty amazing masterpiece of a background there. You can cut this up, use it for ATCs, which is what I'm doing for my patrons this month. So yeah, there you go, guys. I hope you enjoyed that. Let's do one more thing just before we say goodbye. I've got a piece of watercolor paper here somewhere. Don't I? Come on. So this is what you get when you're not prepared, when you're trying to do something off the cuff like this. All right, here's a piece of watercolor paper. This is just a postcard. I'm going to move my pan pastels out of the way. And I've got just plain water in a spray bottle. Just going to spray that. You've seen this done a bunch of times, but what's one more, right? Oh, yum. Yeah. So I'm going to keep playing with that. You guys have a crafty day. Enjoy your Thursday. Bye-bye.